When I was younger, I remember being in the pool for hours on end and I would burn every vacation. And so I really need to be careful with my kids. I don't want them to get the kind of exposure to the sun that I got when I was a child.
Like a lot of parents, Jamie Robin worries about protecting her kids from the sun, and for a good reason.
About 80% of your sun damage can happen before the age of 18. And one blistering sunburn will increase your risk of skin cancer by 50%. It's one of the only kinds of cancers that we really can prevent, but we have to start young.
But it isn't always easy when it comes to protecting active little ones.
We are very exposed and need to be really, really cautious. Both of the boys are definitely outdoor kids. They're sporty kids. They're gone for 7 hours at day camp and I'm not with them. And we can't always rely on a counselor to put sunscreen on 15 kids.
Dr. Amy Brodsky says it's all about maximizing protection. The Pediatric Sun Protection Foundation's working on a study to determine the effectiveness of sun protective clothing. Dr. Brodsky hopes their work will bring sun protective clothing into the mainstream and ultimately lead to a decrease in skin cancer.
A normal t-shirt, a white cotton t-shirt, is anywhere between an SPF of 5 and an SPF of 7. So what that basically means is that, yes, you will probably not burn through that shirt, and the UVB rays are what's causing you to burn. But through that shirt, you'll also get UVA rays. You wouldn't send your child out on a bicycle without a bicycle helmet. So why would you send your child to camp or to the pool without a sun protective shirt?
The more and more exposure to that certain area, the more likely you are to get skin cancer as an older person or as an adult. So I really am very serious with my kids, and they know about swim shirts and sunscreen. Even on a cloudy day, we wear a swim shirt. It's just more a habit and it's routine, and I feel like if we do it every day, it just becomes the norm.
Between ages 0 to 5, we have control over our kids. We can put them in shirts, we can put them in sunscreen. You have to drive these behaviors with your children early, because after a certain age, it's too late.
Dr. Brodsky urges parents to start these habits now so they stick later.
3 tips that I would give to moms: always use the sun protective shirts. Those are SPF 100. Sunblock, you want to apply it every 2 hours. You want to look for something that's the highest number of zinc, and you want to make sure that you're using at least 2 ounces. And then try to protect their eyes too. Kids' eyes are so vulnerable, and so sunglasses would be a must.
I think it helps when the parents role model for their kids. You know, when I go on vacation now, I can see me putting on the sunscreen and putting on a hat and sitting under an umbrella. So I think by us also role modeling as a parent that this is what I do, so you should do the same, I think that's part of the message.
With a little persistence, Jamie says she's noticing results that will hopefully pay off for years to come.
We were on vacation and in the morning my kids said, oh, we forgot to put on our sunscreen. So we can see that it's starting to register with them in the sense that they know something's missing if they go out in the sun without it.